sign says it's the gateway to East and Central Africa. But at Busia, on Kenya's border with Uganda, a queue of lorries snakes back as far as the eye can see. The road here has become a lorry park where drivers wait for days to cross, a sign of how increased health checks, including testing, are putting the brakes on trade. And that's even as a Pan-African Free Trade Zone is due to be launched on January the 1st. That date was put back by 6 months amid lockdown restrictions. But at Busia, and with 2021 approaching, Kenyan driver Joseph Kamani says a crossing that used to involve a five-hour wait can now take 5 days.
Today is the third day here. We have been here on this queue now. And the queue moves at night a bit, but during the day it stops completely. It stalls. The vehicles are like this. And where we are here, as you can see, there is no sanitary equipment.
He and other drivers say the queue can stretch back more than 35 miles. To cross the border, they need to show a negative test taken in the previous 14 days. Failing that, they must submit to testing at the border and wait 2 days for the result. That's created big delays on a transport corridor that extends from Kenya's port Mombasa into landlocked nations such as Rwanda, South Sudan and the Democratic Republic of Congo. Those four, along with 50 other countries, have signed up for the African Continental Free Trade Area, which aims to bring 1.3 billion people together in a $3.4 trillion economic bloc. Its Secretary General said last week that innovative arrangements will be required, as not all the customs infrastructure will be ready in time. Kenya's government says delays at Busia will be reduced once an approach road is turned into a dual carriageway, a project due for completion in 2022. But until then, life on the road for the drivers in Busia has become exactly that.